said that this is the environment. We are going up there, and then we are going to camp here. We are almost at the top of this mountain. Beautiful trail in this good environment. Anyway, as soon as we get there, I'll set up the fire, gather some wood and cook a good steak on it. So let's do it, guys. I only miss a bit my dog, because I always like to share my adventures with him. Next time he will be with me. As you can hear from my steps, the ground is full of grass, of dead leaves. So we have to be careful about the fire, not to cause any damage, as I always do. Anyway, the wood safety is always one of my priority. So I never take any risk making a fire. And I never had any doubt if I can provoke an accidental fire. It can never happen for my bad interpretation of the conditions of the environment and the weather. You always have to be very careful about accidental fire. For me, there is no option. These are the spice that I found yesterday in the other video I've shown you, and I will use them for my beef, my steak. Now, as you can see, I've gathered a few rocks to make a circle and put my fire right here. Eventually I will use another of these rocks here to make my grill, because I don't have one. So few sticks, two rocks, and sticks over here, the brace down here, and the meat here. Anyway, you will see. I can find only dry leaves to make a burner, but I guess it will be enough. Okay. You know what, guys? I guess, given the sun is not collaborating, I will use the fire steel on the charcoal here, which as you will see is really good, because you won't need much sparks, just a, just one spark and it will catch the fire with no problem. Okay. You will need to leave the chocolate to leave it to work for a while with just the leaves. It's not like you have a burnest made of fine material, so it has to work a bit more to start. This is a killer. As I said, you need to have a bit more of patience with the leaves, but the result is the same as always. I guess this wood will be enough for my stick. I can say that it's going very well. part of the stainless steel is also this. It doesn't mind the blood. Those are the plants of yesterday. Piece of beauty. What do you think, guys? They're gonna smell really good and taste even better. Forgot to make a fork. This is delicious, guys. I just have put the other piece of stick here to keep it warm. The stone is really hot, so it's perfect to keep the food. See, the rocks are really hot. You see smoke coming from my stick. Better. And now, guys, it's time to move to the sleeping room. Do you like it? It's not much, but it's home. Just want to show you something, guys. That's interesting for you that see me from home. The particular type of trail that I have just made make this singular point interesting for you guys, because from here you can see almost everything of the trail that I've made. Just a second. Here you see I have climbed this part here, then over there and back in that valley there. And you see the curve there is where I have started and where I have shown you these rocks where I'm standing right now. You see the trail is right there, then up here, and then here where I am. In this beautiful top. Someone of you asked me what I use to strop my knives, my blades, and it's really simple. I just cut it a piece of chestnut wood that I found in my place. I make with my axe, I make this piece of wood, and I stitched pieces of leather on the sides, and I use the compounds. I also put the numbers here and here to recognize the the compound that I'm using, because after a few strops the color is the same. This small size I use it on the field. Then I have a longer one to use at home. Some people told that you shouldn't use strop the Scandi Edge, and in some way they are right, because stropping with the leather a Scandi Edge, it will become a bit convex, and so it's not a perfect Scandi. This is the Scandi Edge, okay? If you strop it, you make it like this. This is a simplification, but it's like this. To have again a Scandi Edge, you have to remove much material of the blade. So this is the reason why many people doesn't like, many people who really loves Scandi Edge doesn't like stropping the leather. For me, a bit Scandi Edge, micro Scandi on the edge, it's not a problem. And you make with the stropping, you make the knife really sharp, and in the field is easier. You don't take the whetstone with you on the field. Actually, you can't remove the chipping or blending on the blade. Small blending you can fix it with the stropping, but if you have a chip on the blade, especially when you use a stainless steel like this, use a stainless steel blade like this, even if it's Elmax, which is a really a good steel. Anyway, the stainless steel suffer from chipping, because it's really hard. So sometimes you will encounter some chipping, and that's impossible to remove with the stropping. You have to work on the whetstones. I have always used carbon steel blades, and this is the first time I use a stainless steel, but I have to say that it's not that bad, and the way that it doesn't rust, and you can put it in the water, forget it, in the snow, no problem. Also the blood on the meat is not a problem, so it's good for me.
See you soon, guys.